It was fun to begin with, but I'm trying to figure out now how I can get out. Tell me what I can do. How can I get out now?
No! No!
I wanted everybody to know that things were changed around here.
We had to make an example of these pricks that the party was over.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Want to do me a favor? You want to take your feet off the table and put your shoes back on?
Fuck you.
I'm just curious. I saw you shuffling your checks with your right hand. Can you do that with both hands?
No.
Can't do it with both hands?
No, sir.
I want you to exit this guy off the premises, and I want you to exit him off his feet and use his head to open the fucking door.
So you're right.
Yeah.
You fucking faggot! Do you know who you're fucking with?
You called my friend a faggot? You told him to go fuck himself? Is that what you did? You told him to go fuck himself? You fucking hick! You fucking hick! Come here. You go over there right now, you apologize.
If it goes bad for me, it's gonna go bad for a lot of people,
yeah,
understand?
Forget about your fucking license. I plant my own flag out here. You ain't gonna need a fucking license.
So in Green's absence, then you're the boss.
I serve at the pleasure of the chairman of the board, and my responsibilities are to run the day-to-day operations.
So day-to-day, then you're the boss.
You're in the finances, you're upstairs, but you are not on the floor. You don't see what's going on. I've got thousands of players, I got 500 dealers. They're all looking to rob me blind 24 hours a day. I have to let them know I'm watching all the details all the time.
Well, in a sense, you could say that I am the boss when Mr. Green is away. You could say that.
You know goddamn well somebody had to get into those machines and set those fucking reels. The probability on one four-reel machine is 1.5 to 1. On 3 machines in a row, it's in the billions. It cannot happen. Would not happen. You fucking Momo, what's the matter with you?
Every time they mention my name in the papers, these cocksuckers, they mention Nikki too. How the fuck does that help? I mean, the heat he brought down is murder. Got a police department who was cooperative. He's pissed them off so much now that nobody can make a move anymore.
The more I talk to you, the more I feel like you just don't want to go along with me. Is that it?
Oh, I don't want to come along with you. I'll be honest with you. I had it with you. I've been carrying your ass in this place ever since I got here. Get your ass and get your things and get out of here.
You're firing me?
I'm firing you. No, I'm not firing. I'm firing you.
You might regret this, Mr. Rothstein.
I'll regret it even more if I keep you on.
You won't allow me a hearing? You didn't even look at the FBI reports. When you were my guest, Mr. Chairman, Senator, at the Tangiers Hotel, did you not promise me that I would have a fair hearing?
I was never your guest at the Tangiers.
You were never my guest? I never comped you?
What's he doing? He knows all those guys he yelled at are friends of ours. What's the matter with him, making all this mess?
Back up. Do you remember what I told you? One minute. I asked you... When the fuck did I ever ask you if I could come out here?
You can't be serious. How can I walk away? Don't you see what's going on here? Don't you see what's at stake?
The old man said, maybe your friend should give in. And when the old man says maybe, that's like a papal bull. Not only should you quit, you should run.
You want me to get out of my own fucking town?
Yeah, I said let the bullshit blow over for a while so I can run the casino. Anything goes wrong with the casino, it's my ass. It's not yours, it's my ass.
I don't know whether you notice or not, but you only have your fucking casino because I made that possible.
That's all that I'm saying. I would forget about the maneuver. I would just get out.
I can't do that.
You know damn well I was at that dinner, and you swore to me that I would have a fair hearing at that dinner. Did you not? Did you not?
Get this through your head, you. Get this through your head, you Jew motherfucker, you. You only exist out here because of me.
Well, tell me I was at least at the dinner. Allow me that much. Give me that much at least.
He's on all night screaming about how he's going to take his damn lawsuit all the way to the Supreme Court. He really must be crazy.
Without me, you... Personally, every fucking wise guy still around, I'll take a piece of your fucking Jew ass. Then where you gonna go?
Yes, you were.
Yeah, thanks for not calling me a liar, son of a bitch.
Your fucking warrant don't ever go over my fucking head again, you motherfucker, you.
I saw Vegas one way.
You call this guy and tell him I'm coming?
Of course. But I saw it another. I saw it as untouched. I mean, they had bookies, pimps, and drug dealers I could shake down. Who the fuck were they gonna run to? So I started getting everybody in line. Best of all, for the first time in my life, I figured out a way not to lose.
Yeah, he had a foolproof scheme, all right. It wasn't very scientific, but it worked. When he won, he collected. When he lost, he told the bookies to go fuck themselves. What were they gonna do, muscle Nicky? Nicky was the muscle.
Hi.
Hey.
How you doing?
How you doing?
Good, yeah. You got that thing for me?
What thing? Oh, Nicky, I thought you was laying.
I'm laying? No, I'm taking it. I was taking it.
You sure?
I'm positive.
I'm a little confused.
You look confused? Maybe if I stick your fucking face through this window over here, like, you know, you'll get unconfused. Give me the fucking money.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean anything by it.
Yeah, I know. That's why you had it ready. You thought I was fucking laying it?
My fucking head.
Your fucking head, huh?
Down the road, virtue runs the bottom line. May come a winner, bless your bet, make you wager. Take a teaser like a rummy, couple of dogs and let them roll. The rent is due, the woman's gone. May you come a winner. You wager. You bet with your heart. Your heart takes the burning pain. You bet with your soul and you're doomed. With no bet at all, you're still paying for your life. The old man looked me in the eye.
Bookmaking is a most profitable enterprise for organized crime, which provides two essential services to the individual bookmaker: laying off his bets and furnishing the information he needs to calculate his odds. The largest amounts of money are bet on sports events: football, basketball, ice hockey, and baseball. Horse betting, once the bookmaker's standby, is next in volume. A successful bookmaking operation depends upon rapid relay of odds, line information, and results. Expert sports handicappers, often employed by organized crime, provide the analysis upon which odds are based. Team and player records and condition, location of the game, probable weather. The bookmaker uses long-distance phone to get this information fast and frequently. He also makes out-of-town calls to the bankers of organized crime to lay off his bets and keep the book in balance. So that these incriminating toll calls are not charged to the apartment he rents for a few hours each day, he has attached to the telephone an electronic device, the Blue Box. Like all evasive devices, it violates telephone company regulations. The Blue Box circuitry permits the user to make toll-free, unrecorded, and untraceable calls wherever direct distance dialing is available. Through the Blue Box phone, the bookmaker gets the latest point spreads on the college games he is booking. On football or basketball, the bettor usually wagers $11 on a pick'em basis to win 10. Point spreads reflect the handicapper estimate of the competing teams. Baseball bets are usually placed at varying odds, based upon the pitchers for the day, as well as the team record. To receive the incoming calls from bettors on which his livelihood depends, the bookmaker relies on several devices, which may keep his location or private phone secret. One is the backstrap, a simple circuit which connects the bookmaker's unauthorized extension to an authorized and listed telephone at a nearby but separate and clean location. Another way to prevent his incoming calls being traced or his location revealed is by installing a black box, a somewhat more complex electronic device. It absorbs the electrical impulses on incoming calls so that they do not record at the telephone company's central billing equipment. This bookmaker, however, uses the more sophisticated cheese box to conceal his location and private telephone number. He maintains a private phone elsewhere than the apartment from which he works, with a number known only to him. He keeps an open line from his apartment to this phone at prearranged hours known to his customers. They have a different number to call, connecting them with still another phone, which may be in an empty room or other clean location. This call is switched through the cheese box to the bookmaker's private phone, also in a clean location. Then, during the hours that he monitors this phone from his apartment, he can converse with the customer who has called an entirely different number to reach him. Other elements in the elaborate screen of deception may be markers or records on instantly disposable water-soluble or flash paper. But even the tightest screen will not shield against vigorous and uncompromising police work. Informants are a prime source for discovery of illegal gambling. They may be on a police payroll, regular bettors, competitors, or disgruntled employees. This is a housewife who has discovered where most of her husband's paychecks are going: betting on sports. She gives the detectives the accommodation number that she knows her husband calls to make wagers. Even then, it is not easy to find the bookmaker's actual location. The telephone company will aid in tracing it through the maze of electronic evasion. Having located the apartment that the bookmaker works from a few hours each day, they keep it under surveillance. They learn the daily routine and plan for a legal yet fast entry when the action is heaviest, evidence most plentiful. The bookmaker is off the cheese box open line. With all bets in for that day, he finds that to balance his book and ensure a profit, he must lay off some heavily played teams. It is time to call the bookmaker's bookmaker, almost always an agent of organized crime. Layoff is big business. Without it, few bookmakers could operate. His heavy work over, he waits expectantly for delivery of his daily sandwich. Information leads to investigation. Investigation to surveillance. Surveillance to apprehension. It pays off. Armed with a warrant, police plan their raid when the maximum evidence would be on hand and with minimum chance for its destruction. There is no cooperation from the bookmaker, but their continuing investigation will uncover other evidence. The unauthorized electronic equipment. The testimony of the not-so-innocent owners of the apartment. They find the water-soluble paper on which the bets were written. And a little black notebook listing the bookmaker's layoff and line odd sources. They lead directly to organized crime. Without organized crime to bank numbers, lay off bets, protect gaming, and bribe some officials and police officers, illegal gambling could be stopped.
Two gentlemen from the FBI to see you, sir.
You, the officer, must be aware of the connection between illegal gambling and organized crime. Only honest, aware, and informed law enforcement officers can bring the organized criminal before the bar of justice. Only incorruptible, impartial, and stern justice can make him pay for his crime. You must be informed on the major types of illegal gambling, their MOs, and the applicable gambling statutes in your jurisdiction. You must be trained in effective techniques to discover the illegal gambling operation through informants, observation, and investigation. To follow the operation as close to the top as possible. To plan the arrests so as to acquire and preserve the necessary evidence for conviction.
$500.
You don't know when to quit, do you, Griswold?
Chips.
Changing 500. Whoop. Here's an idea. Why don't you give me half the money you were going to bet? Then we'll go out back, I'll kick you in the nuts, and we'll call it a day.